I think of really good mentors as people who help me grow.
What mentors do is ask good questions and drive your own personal development and goal setting. There's this great famous article on why Yoda was a bad mentor. He was really directive. Like, he didn't let Luke really grow his own skill.
Fostering professional development is a responsibility of a mentor. How do I get them connected to all of the skills that they need to add to their toolkit as they progress professionally? Fostering independence to raise them to the point that they can go out on their own. Addressing equity and inclusion. Create a lab environment that is inclusive and that allows everybody to bring the best part of them. Fostering well-being. When I was a postdoc, I got involved in a new project and quickly made a complete mess of it. And my advisor called me into his office and said, "You know, you've made a mess of this, but you've made a mess of it for all the right reasons." So it really giving me encouragement, but sent me back out with renewed energy and enthusiasm for trying again. And that was incredibly empowering. One of the misconceptions that students often have about mentorship is that it's one way, it's unidirectional. I will be obtaining wisdom from my mentor. They will be telling me what to do. Students actually drive mentoring relationships, and students can have much better outcomes from their experiences in research when they understand what levers they control to optimize their mentoring relationships.
Thinking about how can I use this relationship so that it's productive and meaningful and beneficial, not only for myself, but also for the mentor. Thinking about how can I be proactive? How can you be coachable? How can you be responsive, thinking about their advice and thinking about and taking it seriously?
You have to come into each mentorship relationship with your own goals and expectations.
The more you invest in it, the more you get out of it.
Can I only have an effective relationship with someone who shares my identities? And those identities can be race, ethnicity, gender, maybe being the first in their family to go to college. The good news is there is research showing that even if your mentor doesn't share your identities, they can still be an effective mentor for you. They have to treat you with respect. They have to understand and listen to your lived experience because they may not have that common lived experience. You can think about those potential missteps in a mentorship relationship at multiple levels. It could be that the mentor is actually engaging in behaviors or has particular characteristics that undermine the experience. Examples include things like, even with good intent, being too busy to provide the kinds of support that the graduate student needs, or more actively harmful behaviors.
Some of the things that aren't okay is someone being very demeaning or personally attacking you. There's a line between critique and feedback and a microaggression or a toxic environment.
Yelling, making fun of the student, undermining them in front of others. Those are not acceptable no matter who you are.
It shouldn't be okay for you to be treated as anything other than a holistic person that deserves attention and support and nurturing.
Real mentorship is about allowing people to explore possibilities and support them as they find out what's right for them.